brought to you by Penguin. Parenting for Humans, written and read by me, Dr. Emma Svanberg. Introduction. Why did we think this was a good idea? When did you decide to become a parent? Was it a conscious decision or something that happened unexpectedly? Do you feel that you were always destined to be a parent? That it was an inevitable part of your life? Or perhaps something that you grappled with and maybe still are? When do you think you became a parent? Was it when you knew a child was going to be coming into your life? Or did you only start to identify with that role months or even years after you first met them? Did you think about what being a parent meant? What it is to begin a lifelong relationship with another human? Perhaps you had some stories in your mind about what parents are and what they do. Stories you've been told since you were a baby yourself. Stories that have, perhaps, set up certain expectations for you about what good parents do, how they behave, even how they feel inside and what they think about. Maybe you haven't had much opportunity to think about those stories. Maybe you'd never really thought of them as stories, but they exist in all of us, in the form of ideals and assumptions. And they can lead to difficult feelings like loss, guilt, and failure when our realities turn out to be quite different. How about your child? If you haven't met your child yet, how do you imagine they will be? Where have those ideas come from? If you have a child in your life already, what ideas did you hold about them? Had you thought about what they'd be like before you met them? Did you assume that you would just know them from the moment you met? Perhaps you had a baby already in your mind, one that had existed as a doll, or a stick, or a train, when you were tiny and carrying around a precious imaginary baby. Or perhaps you didn't think about what a child would be like at all, but more that it felt the right time to consider creating a family because, well, it just did, and that's what people do, right? We hold a lot of stories in us. Stories about what it means to be a parent, what babies and children are like. Stories about the relationship between parents and children. Sometimes these are positive stories from our own childhood that we wish to repeat. Sometimes they are based on our painful experiences, those stories we wish to forget about or rewrite completely. Sometimes these stories are buried deep within us. Sometimes they exist closer to the surface. But at some point in our parenting, we will find ourselves face to face with these stories and the assumptions they contain. We might challenge them and create new stories. Often, though, because we're human and changing stories is a hard thing to do, we hold tighter to them and wonder what we need to do differently to make that story a reality. There's a good chance that one of those stories, or even many of them, are behind you listening to this book. A story like, if I can just figure out the right strategy to manage my child's behaviour, then life will feel easier again. Or, family life feels really hard and maybe this book will give me the answer to change that. Or even, maybe this is the book that will tell me what it is I'm meant to be doing because frankly, I don't have a clue and everyone else seems to have it together and will someone please just tell me what to do because I'm drowning over here. We pick up parenting books because they appear to sell us that fantasy. That if we just do the thing, or say the words, or follow the instructions, everything will be easier. And often, we put them down after the first few pages because they don't provide any easy answers. But what if there aren't any easy answers? What if the story isn't just one story, but many, some of which contradict each other? What if we need to rip up the stories and instead write our own? And keep coming back to them, editing them, and adding new chapters as our children grow and our lives change. Even in our adulthood, we might picture ourselves as heroes in our story, occasionally villains, perhaps. Certainly, we might wish for someone to come and rescue us. For parents, this may not be a knight in shining armour, but a very kind fairy godmother. Once we get to know ourselves better, unravel some of the stories we've brought along with us, challenge some ideals, consider a new story, then quite an amazing thing can happen. We start to see ourselves as we really are. Good bits, bad bits, and the many in the middle bits. Not heroes, just humans. And we start to see our children as they really are too. The bits we love, and the bits we find really annoying, and all the bits we haven't really noticed. We bring our whole selves to our relationship with them, and they are encouraged to bring their whole selves to their relationship with us. That can feel a bit scary, but it can also be profoundly wonderful and make not just our relationships, but our whole lives feel richer. This isn't a parenting book. It's a book about parents. I know that your heart may have sunk a little when I said there were no easy answers. I'm afraid I'm not going to be offering quick tips and easy solutions, because family life is long and changes all the time. And the best solutions involve figuring out how you want to show up in your family. The rest will come. And let's face it, there's no shortage of books about parenting to give you some of those tips once you've finished with me. Instead, I will be asking you a lot of questions to help you find your own answers. And we'll be getting to know you really well, and the things that influence you as a parent and as a person. Through this process, just as when I see people in therapy, you'll gain insight and reduce pressure on yourself as a parent, which will help you find your own answers. While this won't provide a quick fix, I hope it will bring lasting change. So, this is not a book about parenting. This is a book about parents. It's a book about you. When we don't know ourselves well, we find it hard to apply all of the parenting knowledge we pick up from books, blogs, articles, and podcasts to our lives. We can put a baby down to sleep beautifully, but find it impossible to leave that baby lying there because of our own feelings of abandonment. We can recite a perfectly phrased response to a tantruming toddler through gritted teeth with tears stinging our eyes. We can try to timetable in special one-on-one time with our child, but find ourselves shouting because it hasn't gone how we wanted. And what that often leads to is feeling disconnected and helpless and that we're getting it all wrong and we don't know what else to do. So then maybe we try something new. Like listening to this book, for example. All of the parenting advice in the world, all the understanding of child development and knowledge of sleep cycles, consistent boundaries, emotional validation, they can't truly help if you don't understand yourself and how you operate. Because parenting is not a tick box exercise or a recipe to follow. Parenting is a complex dance between multiple complicated and ever-changing human beings. It strips you naked and leaves you defenceless, all while getting to know a whole new person who initially can't do a thing for themselves and continues to surprise you on a daily basis, frequently on your own, with only social media for moral support, and trying to figure out who you are now that you are, apparently, a parent. This also means that you can get to know your real-life actual child a little better.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.